And the United States Postal Service says it's ready to deliver your votes.
Early voting is underway, and Detroit City leaders want to make sure voters have all the information necessary. Secretary of State Jocelyn Benson says over 2.6 million absentee ballots have already been issued statewide.
7 Action News reporter Andrea Isom explains how the Postal Service is laying out the process of receiving all those ballots.
If you have questions about the voting process, the following information is meant to answer them.
I cannot express enough that our voters need to relax, trust the process, don't let the evildoers get in your ear and confuse you.
Detroiters, your city clerk, Janice Winfrey, has some important messages for every single type of voter before the big event. And so does the postmaster of the city of Detroit, Darren Bray.
And I just want you to know that the Postal Service is working very, very hard to deliver all election mail, not only here in Detroit, but across the country. If you are eligible to vote by mail and you choose to do so, you should plan ahead.
To give yourself plenty of time to complete it properly and return it.
Here in the city of Detroit, we've always enjoyed a good relationship with the United States Postal Service.
To serve the citizens of Detroit, those who choose to vote absentee, like Mrs. Winfrey.
We have 30 drop boxes throughout the city of Detroit. We do that for your convenience. We do that so that you can, if you receive a ballot, let's say by October 20th, we suggest you use a drop box just to ensure that it gets to the Department of Election and is able to be processed in a timely fashion.
Now for the folks who want to exercise their rights in person by voting early,
please visit one of our 23 vote centers that are open 7 days a week.
Let's face it, some individuals are anxious, unsure, and having some trouble trusting this whole thing. Like, what if they receive 2 ballots in the mail? Well, you absolutely cannot vote twice because your first ballot will be spoiled and you have to prove it.
And you have to sign an affidavit to show that I've spoiled my first ballot, so I'll get a second ballot.
Lastly, if you prefer to vote in person, November 3rd, on one of the biggest elections this country has ever seen,
every last one of our precincts will be open. Of course, we will have PPE, that's protective gear, available for voters as well as our poll workers. You will be socially distant in that precinct, as well as the vote centers. So please, vote in a way that's most comfortable for you, that's safe for you. Just vote.
If you need more guidance about the voting process, head on over to our website, WXYZ.com. I'm Andrea Isom, 7 Action News.
Andrea, thank you.